Morning, folks. Miserable day, early December. It's a bit warmer than, well, it's going to be a bit warmer than it has been lately, but it's a miserable day that's fine, misty rain, grey, yuck. Anyway, we don't need to worry about that. We're going to do an exercise in blending colour. I've got some cadmium, cobalt blue. I don't usually use that, I haven't used it for years, but I had some in a, here it is, it's an artist quality, but I put some cling film over the tube just to stop it from leaking out. But of course, because I've used it for years, the cap has welded itself into the top. So I will probably get. So I'll see how we get on. But I want to do a sort of a lake scene in the sky, in the sort of style of Turner, not copying Turner or anything like that. You get some. You look at art books and stuff on YouTube. You think, oh, I'd like to do that. Have a go at that. So away we go. So plenty of white. So I'll get some of that out. So we've got cobalt blue, vermilion, some burnt sienna, some cadmium yellow pale. There's some yellow ochre, but I'm not sure I'll use them all. I'm just going to do my own thing, make my own landscape up. But based on some of the techniques that Turner used, and I want a sort of central light with blue cascading down, and then to indicate some hills, well, small hills. And it's based on the Rutland Lake, where we were several weeks ago on a lovely week's holiday. Right, so let's start with a bit of yellow, plenty of linseed, touch of yellow. This is on a piece of oil paper with the membrane on the back, so that the paint will soak in through the surface, but then it will stop when it hits the barrier. So this is really probably going to be a waste of a sheet of lovely paper. But I do like it. It's just under A4. From the start like this. I don't want to make this a lengthy video. I just want to have a go at something that I haven't tried for a while. Now we'll go in for a little bit of the old cad blue. We'll blend all these colours. Change the brush to probably a dirty brush. That's not very good, is it? Won't use that. It's cold up in my studio here. It's a lovely loft room, and we had built a few years ago, or many years ago now. Keep the blue out of my toweling. The titanium white is quite a good white. Just want to lighten this yellow. And just to blend all this. Oh, okay. Now we've got to do some trees and stuff on the bank here. So that'll be a bit more obvious. Let's have a bit of brown, a bit of red, touch yellow. Bit of yellow there. Bit of yellow, bit of paint spray. A bit of blue in there. So I'll get that to, well, reduced in colour. Now we'll put a bit of blue in there. I hope this turns out to be a bit abstract. I'll put a background in. I love the blue, let's have a bit of that. Bit of a hill there, and we'll match it up the other side, or sort of a hill. Doesn't seem about a month ago, we were in Rutland, but a very beautiful place. Now, I know Turner didn't bother about it. The colour, what he does, he's one of probably the greatest artists, not in living memory. Right, let's see if we can. No, that's my towels are getting a bit past it, so let's change it. Thank you. just fallen off. Well, no problem, we'll get some PVA glue. Right, we let that dry off. I'll clean it, and I've got several of these brushes. Another one here, that's a nice couple of rubber bands, scissors. Right, here we go. Back in now. Oh dear. Aye, aye. Oh. Will it be safe? Oh, drat. Oh. Right, let's bring that yellowy bit. Well, let's put a bit more texture in here. So let's have a bit of green. Not sure that works very well, so we'll go back a bit. Thank you. Now, she could... oh, hold on. Let's pull down some of that colour. I'll change the brush, I think. So that one. Now we've got some quite a bit of red on there. Go back to this one, they're probably stuck by now. Dry the linseed oil, but I just want to go over some of that with a bit of that. So, what I can do, I think what I will do with that brush is to finish this, to put a nail through my brushes. Yeah, I've got another one here. Let's get that little bit of that. So I'm trying to blend everything, but keep the shapes. Okay, let's build up the other side a bit. There's a church on this lake that was submerged, well, half submerged when they built the dam. I think 1976. Well, that's either finished or it's a painting. But more than a painting, it's a statement of what can we say? of abstract feeling. Blending pen's always nice to do. All right, let's get some lights back in there. That bit there. Just bend that bit there. See, the paint's still wet, but it's drying into the paper like this. Right, let's put that in there and have a look. Ooh. God, these are really powerful, these clips. I suppose they're clips for batteries, but they work perfectly well for this, but they are quite very, very stiff. Right, get them out. Oops. Sorry about my hat. But it's cold. And I've got quite a few brushes here to sort out. Let's put them there. With that. Well, there we are. An exercise in blending. Yeah, I hope you like that, folks. I'm quite enamoured with it. Right, bye for now. Take care.